In 4 months, Hawaii has gone from one known COVID-19 variant case to more than 550. As more mutations of the virus develop, the urgency for vaccination grows as well. Nikki Schenfeld breaks down what the variants mean for people not vaccinated.
In 2 weeks, Hawaii counted 209 new variant cases, including 7 cases of the highly contagious P1 Brazilian variant. The California variant continues to dominate statewide, making up the majority of cases on Maui and infecting a household on Kauai. The UK variant is also taking hold, while the South African variant has been reported in fewer cases.
Some of them seem to be more contagious. Others seem to not allow our medications to work as well. The monoclonal antibodies are not as effective against them.
To date, the state has sampled roughly 1,600 cases believed to have a mutation, but it's unknown how many are circulating statewide.
We do know, however, that our vaccines are effective against the variants.
Scientists are looking at a new variant of concern out of India, where less than 2% of the country has been vaccinated. India went from 12,000 new daily cases on March 1st to 350,000 daily cases yesterday. That's an increase of nearly 3,000%.
They're thinking that this second wave is really a waning immunity and now almost new infections on top of old infections. I guess the take-home message there is we shouldn't let our guard down. We still need to see that this is really serious and get more people vaccinated.
The so-called double mutant variant out of India has been detected in California. Lieutenant Governor Josh Green says about 38% of Hawaii has received at least one vaccine dose.
The key is if you have herd immunity so that the virus can't take hold, you don't end up seeing your society get a surge. We can take responsibility for small numbers of cases. We can handle them, obviously, in the hospital. But being fully vaccinated as a state, getting somewhere 75 to 80% of our state vaccinated, that's really the win.
He says appointments going unfilled doesn't necessarily mean there is vaccine hesitancy, but lack of urgency, and believes opening to walk-ins will help get more shots in arms.
And I hope that everyone starts accepting walk-ins soon, because a lot of people are out there and they just didn't want to be troubled with the bureaucracy, but they're excited to go and get the vaccine. I think that could be good for 400,000 or 500,000 shots by doing that.
In your opinion, what is the best way to get that urgency message to the people who are on the fence?
In many ways, it's door to door. Talk to your neighbors, talk to your friends, talk to your Rotary Club, because at the end of the day, 2 or 3 out of 10 people may not be vaccinated, and that can make a big difference as to Hawaii's future.
Nikki Schenfeld, KHON2 News, working for Hawaii.